Good morning and welcome to the fourth vlog of our European mega trip here in June 2016. We are having an absolutely fantastic time and definitely one of the best trips we've ever done here at Theme Park Worldwide. Today, we're here at Movie Park in Germany. We've crossed into the German border for the first time so far this trip. And I'm still joined by the one and only PC Poms, Joe Beasley. Or as we're going to call him now, Moped. After we had a little incident with the moped. You all right there, mate? Theme Park Worldwide on YouTube, yeah. And Martin Atwood's here as well.
Hello, and the sun is out.
The sun is out.
So we should be having a fun.
And today, we've got shorts on. The Germans love it. The Germans have been in the back of quite a lot of our videos. I love the Germans. They love us. We're going to have a good day. Look at them all. They all want the attention. Here you go. Give us a scream. We're all attention seekers over here, they love it.
Theme park worldwide!
On YouTube. Yeah, it's our first time at this park. Quite a small park, but we've got 6 credits to get. English people vlogging, yeah. Yes, are you all excited?
What's your YouTube channel?
Theme park worldwide.
Theme park worldwide,
yeah.
Okay.
Check it out. Come on. Bye. So yeah, it's our first time at the park. 6 roller coaster credits to get. And apparently one of the roughest roller coasters we're ever going to ride, which is Bandits, a wooden roller coaster manufactured by the Roller Coaster Corporation of America. We've also got a suspended looping coaster. We've also got an indoor Gerslauer bobsled coaster, which looks absolutely fantastic, and I can't wait to ride it. The theming of Van Helsing's factory looks stunning. I'm getting there with my voice. It's starting to go a little bit, but I'm going to try my best for you guys. It's going to be a good day. Are you ready?
I absolutely am.
Are you ready? Let's go and see the Movie Park Germany. Inside the park, home 10 o'clock till 6 p.m. this one, and already I think Joe summed this up well. What's it remind you of?
Universal.
It is. It's just like Universal Studios. I mean, obviously all the buildings and trying to make it feel like you're on a street. Yeah, Hollywood, all these different signs. I like it. It's got a really good feel to it, actually.
Sunset Boulevard.
Again, we've not been to this park before, so we don't have a clue where we're going. So I've got my map just here. I think we're going to head to the Gerslauer bobsled coaster that opened in 2011, known as Van Helsing's Factory. And that is a ride that I've wanted to ride ever since it first opened.
Have you seen what's in the 4D cinema?
Not Ice Age.
Ice Age 4D,
no time for nuts.
I saw that. No time for nuts.
No time for going in that either.
No, I don't think we need to.
We've got that apart closer to home. For any German viewers watching who don't realise, we've basically got that at a theme park in the UK called Alton Towers. And if you've not seen that before, check out Alton Towers on the channel. We're going to take a left turn just here, I think. There it is down the bottom, Van Helsing's Factory. This looks so well themed. Probably one of the best themed roller coasters in Europe, actually. I've got really high expectations from this, so I really hope that I've not sort of built it up too much in my mind and find it a bit of an overhype. Don't think I will have, though. It looks really good.
Certainly looks like the best themed Gerslauer.
Yeah, the exterior is nice.
Doesn't look like a Gerslauer, it doesn't look like
Well, the whole thing's inside, and look at that, you got the cars on top, and you got the fans spinning. It reminds me of Saw the Ride a little bit.
It's the only thing that's put me off about this ride, the fact that it is a Gerslauer.
You'll be fine. It's a family coaster. Let's go and give it a ride. Look at this. absolutely fantastic in there. Again, with that ride, it wasn't as expected. It was better than expected. It exceeded everything that I'd hoped for that ride. The whole thing was so well themed. You got a couple of lift hills in there and some amazing forces. What you can't obviously see from a POV of that ride is the fact right in it, there's a massive S-bend. You know, it's not banked at all. It's literally, you throw yourself to the side.
A little bit of a wild mouse in places inside there. But I'm telling you, amazing theming. So dark inside, and it's a very, very dark theme to it, and it's got some amazing effects in there.
It has.
It's got some like projection mapping. It's got brilliant effects in there.
Yeah, lots of screens around there. As you're going up the lift hill, it's got screens. As you're going around, you've got like some air cannons in there. You know, lots of good atmospheric lighting going on. And it was quite a dark sort of ride, but the whole thing was themed. Just because they didn't think, right, we'll theme the station and the lift hill, and then after that we'll just have it as a dark coaster. They thought, no, we're going to theme that all the way around. There's barrels all the way around, loads of atmospheric lighting, and I would say that's one of my favourite indoor roller coasters in Europe.
Yeah,
you know, that was really, really good. And a fantastic ride. That there, you know, is one look out of place at a major European park. They've done a really good job with that, and it gives me really high hopes for what Movie Park Germany are going to do in the future. But yeah, it was really good, really intense. There's a couple of good helixes on there, and not the longest of rides, but I'd rather have a short ride that packs a punch and have amazing theming than something that's long and boring and not heavily themed. So what do you think to it then, Joe?
Yeah, really good. I've really enjoyed that a lot. The smoke screen in there was particularly good effect.
Oh yeah, I forgot to mention that,
actually. Smoke screen, you come now, it's right towards the end of the ride, but you've got a couple of screens before where you come up the lift hill and you duck underneath the screens, and then you'll be right at the end, just before it comes into the brake run, you've got this mist screen, and it was projecting onto that, and then you go straight through it. You think you're just going to go straight through like a, you know, plaster screen or whatever, you know, it's crazy.
Yeah, it was really good. It was very, you know, it was very well done, that was. And like I say, for me, I was going in there with very high expectations, and to come out and still think that that was amazing and higher than what I was expecting means it's a really good ride. So yeah, very impressed with that. And of course, probably one of my favourite rides of the trip that we've done. Not my favourite of the trip, but my favourite indoor coaster of the trip, definitely. Yeah, it was very, very good. Really enjoyed that. Joe, what the hell are you bringing me on?
Another SLC, because we love them.
You are joking. This is the third Vekoma suspended looping coaster of the trip. Three of the damn things. And yesterday, we rode the worst Vekoma SLC I've ever been on. It was absolutely awful. It was Al Condor, Wallaby Holland, and it was absolutely dreadful. The worst roller coaster I've ever ridden.
Just think though, Sean, we haven't got any more to go on after today.
Yes, and the other thing is...
that is the best thing about it.
Things can only get better, can't they, at the end of the day. You know, we're leading up to the B&Ms, we're going to be back on Black Mamba, back on Baron 1898. So let's get on. Access denied. Why the hell is the returns tally here? Not too bad at all. Oh, that wasn't actually too bad. Probably one of the best SLCs I've ever been on. If not, the best one, actually. I didn't think that was rough at all. I thought that was quite smooth.
I'd say it's just below Blue Tornado for me.
Yeah. I think Blue Tornado is probably the best.
Yeah.
And then that was no problem at all. I've been on B&Ms that have been rougher than that before. Yeah. You know,
it's just an old coaster.
That was not that bad, like, at all.
The inversions themselves were quite comfortable. Just a few knocks on the corners, but like, it's an old coaster.
Still not a massive fan. I wouldn't really rank it in any sort of high ratings or anything, but it wasn't too bad. It was one of the better ones that I've ever ridden. That a lot better than yesterday's. You know, oh, that was dreadful.
That was the worst one yesterday. That one, it wasn't the worst SLC I've been on.
It was still rubbish.
It wasn't themed. It wasn't themed, but it did help that they actually had a little bit of cushion on the edge of.
Yes.
where your head is.
Very good point there, actually, by Martin.
Yeah, so that did help an awful lot.
Yeah, maybe that's why.
Ease the pain.
You could tell it was just running a lot better. Bearing in mind that only in 2001, so yeah, that wasn't bad. Obviously, still, you know, not great. But
no.
Out of the ones that I've done,
right. It just wasn't themed at all.
I was braced after yesterday. I was braced and my hands were on the bar. I was ready to go. And, you know, as you probably heard from the POV, I was quite happy on that
we
one.
We didn't even get to look at it off-ride to see how it rode off-ride.
Yeah, it was just straight on.
We were the first ones on it, so.
We're going to have a look at Bandit, the wooden roller coaster, but I'm not sure if it's open yet. It doesn't look very busy around there. So we're going to have a little look. Impressions of the park so far?
It's like a better theme than I thought it was going to be like.
Yeah.
Today was going to be the start of the really well themed ones, but it looks like they spend more money here on theming than they do actually on the rides themselves.
Yeah, it's quite nice so far, isn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah. It is well themed. I mean, and it's clean. I mean, it is a lot actually better than I was expecting. I mean, I can't really see at the moment why they don't really get the guests actually coming in to the park. We obviously haven't been here all day yet.
So. Yeah, it's looking good so far. Obviously, to try and bring more guests in, they've got a new attraction for 2016, which is the Walking Dead Breakout, which unfortunately isn't ready for our trip. But the Walking Dead seems to be something that's coming into a lot of parks. In fact, me and Dean did it the other week when we were out at Parked Attractions, where there was a scare maze walkthrough. Obviously, it's at Universal Halloween Horror Nights every year, you know. So, yeah, hopefully this will be quite a good day when that's finished.
Well, this park is actually owned by the same company that owns... Park Warner.
So they've obviously got the rights to using that license. So
yeah, they are using the same attractions an awful bit. But I am quite sad to see that ride's not open because I am a massive fan of The Walking Dead.
It's a shame, but yeah. Like I say,
RIP, I think, for all these parks.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to getting back to Halloween Horror Nights in September, where of course we're going to be having 18 days of vlogs from Orlando with me and Chris Franklin coming up September later this year, so a couple of months to go till we're back out in the States. So let's go on our next ride. Next up then, we're going on the High Fall. Quite an interesting name. And this is basically a roto drop from Roller Coaster Tycoon or a gyro drop, as they're also known.
Hello.
This is quite well themed, isn't it? Hello. Going to be on, there you go. Theme bar worldwide on YouTube. Check it out. The Germans love it.
It's themed Q-line to a roto drop.
So. It's quite nice, isn't it, around here? Yeah. We'll go and get on. Hello. Drop tower, I was very impressed with that. I mean, with it being, you know, you got some force in you, definitely an intermin there as well. You know, we got some great force, stand up, and it also the seats tilted quite a bit. So you're facing looking down as you saw from the footage. I was just going, hey, theme park worldwide on YouTube. Yeah, movie park Germany.
Yes.
But yeah, what did you guys think to it? It's good.
Yeah, really good. Yeah, one of the better drop towers we've done, I think. Not quite as good as Scream at Heidi Park because that has the height as well. But yeah, really good. Really good force on that.
Fantastic, wasn't it? But I really enjoyed it. That was a little gem. I wasn't expecting to find a ride like that quite here. It was fantastic. Neither was I expecting to find a complete copy of something what's in Nickelodeon Land of Blackpool Pleasure Beach. Avatar Air Glider. Oh yeah. Not the Avatar Airbender with the best staff ever. It's the Avatar Air Glider. Look at that. And here's where our other three credits are. Obviously, we've not got the Woody yet. It is closed at the moment. Hopefully, well, we best get that. I was very, very happy about missing another cred. But yeah, we got this, we got a Matt Wild Mouse, and then we got a couple of other junior characters, and a very well-themed log flume over there by the looks of it. Obviously Nickelodeon land. Should we start with the Matt, shall we?
Yeah.
Start with the Matt Classic. Look at this, this is quite nice. That looks quite good as well, actually. Nice views of the park. He has some good force on these corners. This is good. Oh, this has got some kick to it. Airtime machine. This is good. Oh, right. Here we go. Whoa, floating. Had a good ride then on the Mack Wild Mouse. Really, really good that actually. Got some quite nice air times, quite nice elements on the ride. What's good on this other credit now, another junior credit within Nickland. Just read on the map actually, it's the largest Nickland in Europe. So there you go, take that one, Blackpool Pleasure Beach. Do you enjoy the map?
I wasn't too impressed with that, to be honest.
What was up with it, do you
think? Well, I don't like Wild Mouse rides, number one. And it does look a bit off the shelf, the ride, and this whole area just kind of seems a bit amusement park.
Very America, very Cedar Fair. It reminds me of Knott's Berry Farm a little bit, actually.
I think it looks very, very amusement park. Really, to be honest, and the theming is very, very basic.
It's better than no theming though, which is good.
Yeah.
But with this one here, it's a Vekoma, and this actually opened in 1996 under a different theme. But it's not looking too bad for its age, you know. Hopefully, it'll ride not too rough. Little Vekoma Junior Coaster, let's go for a ride. So far, though, I'm really impressed actually with Movie Park. It's a lot better than I was anticipating. I thought it was going to be flatland, not many trees, tarmac, few rides on, with Van Helsing stuck right in the middle, which was amazingly themed. And it's not that. There's actually a lot more to it, isn't there? You know, and
yeah,
it's a nice theming.
Yeah, I would agree with that. I can tell that they are like, I'm struggling to find the staff here because of, as we're walking into the park, it was more like managers on the turnstiles.
Yes, it was, yeah.
And more than actual turnstile staff themselves.
Turnstile staff.
But yeah. Have we got any shorts on the entrance to greet you?
See, Marco's facing up. There we go. So let's go and have a ride on the Vekoma. This looks quite good. Standard layout, I think, this one. Pretty much like Tammy, isn't it?
Have they changed the trains on this?
They look like they've either been, the shells have been updated, don't they? So we'll have a ride and let you know what we think. Then we've got a really special one coming up after that. We've got a 2007 Vekoma suspended coaster just over there, family suspended coaster. And that log flume, it looks well themed.
That's had a re-theme as well.
I think a lot of this was probably re-themed when they got the Nickelodeon license.
Yeah.
So let's go and have a go. Enjoyed Mission to Mars there, as it's all from the on-ride footage. Nice Vekoma Junior, pretty much standard layout there, where, you know, standard force, didn't it? Rode quite smooth, that one, so yeah, it was good. Yeah, enjoyed
Tammy,
yeah. We're going to go and try...
A bit of
it was all right, wasn't it? We've got another Vekoma now, a bit of a newer one. 2007 Vekoma. It's a Vekoma family suspended coaster. So we'll check this out. Basically now, if you wanted to buy one of these, it'd pretty much end up being like, you know, the new rides that have gone into the Lost Kingdom. Vekoma have definitely upped their game. I mean, if you look at that, and then look at Flight of the Pterosaur, you know, what's opened back home at Poulton's Park in the Lost Kingdom, then, you know, it makes you realise how much Vekoma are up in their game at the moment. But yeah, I'm sure this will be all right. We're going to give it a go. Jimmy Neutron's Atomic Flyer, and this opened in 2007. Quite enjoying the Vekoma suspended, actually. It was really good. Obviously, you could tell how smooth it was. We'd opened it in 2007, and it was just generally a good ride, quite floaty, quite enjoyable. And we also got an automatic second ride. We came in, it was like, yeah, jump back on, we'll go round again, which is good. So obviously, they don't really mind the re-rides here at Movie Park. We're just getting some food now, quite early today, as we're going to go and watch our first show of the trip, which is a stunt show, which looks good. And Joe's just ordering some food here, so...
We'll eat in.
So this is basically a clever way of ordering food. All you need to do is select what you want, like Martin's doing here. He looks at the menu. He presses what he wants. You can't pick. Good choice. Then he selects what he wants, and then clicks pay, and then you can pay on card, put your notes in there and coins in there. So we'll get some food, have some Sean's food review. And you can guess what I'm having already, probably. If you ever ask for a large fries at a movie park, that is what you get. There's so many. Yeah, that's literally enough to feed two people. Mm. So I'm going to give some to Joe. But oh, wait, he's got one as well. Yeah. And I bet Martin's got one as well. I only click large because I wanted a large drink, to be honest. But yeah. And of course, there they are. Look just like Mackie's nuggets, they do. Literally just look like McDonald's nuggets. Right.
I'm here now.
Yeah, and Martin got large as well. Look how many fries you get.
And look how many drinks I've got.
You've got two.
I'm thirsty, yeah.
We'll have to go and watch a show shortly, so we're going to eat this. Joe's going to have his Ben and Jerry's. He loves a good cookie dough. Is it? Oh no, chocolate fudge brownie. Oh no. Not, it's quite nice, but I still like my cookie dough. Just saying, actually, this reminds me of Walt Disney Studios at Disneyland Paris. It's got some really nice themed areas, and then other areas it's quite bland and it's quite open. Whereas this in here, you know, it just reminds me of Walt Disney Studios, something you find in Studio One, the big entrance area at Paris. So, yeah, I'm going to eat this and we'll see you at the show. Here you go, have a chip. Poms, 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 pom, pom, poms. Moped. This sort of central plaza area of the park, very Hollywood, Beverly Hills, really nice area, of course. We're having a really good day so far. It's a lot nicer park than expected. We've still got one credit which we need to get, and that's Bandit, the wooden coaster, which we haven't been back down that end yet. So hopefully that's going to be back open, fingers crossed, and we're going to get that credit. I really hope so. It's not open yet today. So we're going to go watch a stunt show now, the 12 o'clock stunt show here in Studio 6. It's Crazy Cops of New York. So this looks quite good. I've heard some good things about this, and hopefully we'll get a bit of fire in here as well. So let's go and give it a go. Stunt show, our first show of the trip. We've got quite a few to see because Efteling's got some great shows. Fantasyland's got some of the best shows I've ever seen in Europe. So yeah, let's go and have a look at the venue.
It does look really good, this
It does, doesn't it? Yeah, it's a really nice sort of entrance area as well, isn't it? Look at this, really nice theme in here. Love it. Very universal. Up sound.
Links und zum Beispiel.
Oh, I wasn't expecting that. That was brilliant, that was. Look at that. So much pyro, so many effects. Whoa! Oh, brilliant! You know how much I love fire. This is like the ideal show. Brilliant. So much action. Very good, very good. Yeah. To that show. Marty, I'll start off with you.
That really was amazing. Such good effects all the way through. And it didn't even matter the fact that it wasn't in English at all. As you can understand what was vaguely going on, you know, a person was stealing money and all the cops. That was right up the standard of an actual Disney standard that I've seen.
Yes.
In my opinion, the best show that I have seen in Europe. And you just imagine how much money they are throwing away on the tyres for that show, on all the cars for that show.
The special effects.
And how much it costs to actually run a show like that.
Thousands of pounds a show.
I mean, I can't really understand why this park can't really get the guests into this park.
Now maybe we've done this vlog. They might do. What do you think, Joe?
Really good. Action-packed is like the best way to describe it. Just non-stop action. The margin for error in the driving on that circuit as well is very, very minimal. So I can imagine if they do mess up, it costs them a fortune to put things right again, you know? But yeah, really good.
And you love cars, don't you, as well?
I love cars.
I was watching a bit in that show. He was, enjoying that. There was a few... You know,
I just wish I had some skills like that with my driving.
You realise, Martin, in the drive home on this vlog, you're going to see Martin doing that.
Oh, I don't think so, somehow.
Oh, and the Woody is on. The Woody is on. Yes, we're going to get Bandit. But yes, that was one of my favourite shows in Europe. And I'm got a big, bold statement now. Bold 2-in-1. That was the best theme park stunt show I've ever seen.
I agree with that. I wouldn't say it's the best show I've ever seen.
No.
But definitely the best...
The best stunt show
I've seen, yeah.
What I loved mostly about that, of course, was pyro. We had some lots of big pyro explosions, fire effects, smoke, some really good action. Of course, what Martin said, really, the fact that we're English, we don't understand German at all, and that was very, you know, there was a couple of minutes talking, then it was straight back into the action. How many cars did them guys own? There was like about, what, 10 different vehicles?
It was five different police cars, and then there was at least sort of five different, like, bandit cars, if you know what I mean, like, so...
Bandit cars, I like your little hint there for the next ride.
Yeah, next ride. Cars on the run, you know, the baddies, yeah.
Absolutely, 10 out of 10, you could not fault that show in any way. Action-packed, I know that went on for quite a few minutes in the vlog there, but you guys needed to see quite a lot of that. That's the best thing at this park, in my opinion.
I would like to see that show again, actually, for the second show. There is actually two shows of this show in a day.
So if you do miss it, you've got a chance to see it later on. Don't miss that. That is one of the gems of Europe that we knew a little bit about, but not too much. Obviously, the Woody's now open, Bandit, so we're going to go and give that a go and see just how bad it is. Okay. It's our last coaster of this park. Credit number 6 for us. It's Bandit, a roller coaster manufactured by the Roller Coaster Corporation of America. Let's go and have a ride. That was absolutely 10 out of 10. Right, so we're on Bandit, and I don't actually think this is going to be great. Like, look at this restraint here. I've got this, which is banging against me. I've got a headrest there. I don't think this is going to be very good at all.
No.
But it's got nice views.
Definitely not.
We're about to find out. I really do not understand why everybody says that is rough. That was not that bad at all. That's not even in my top five rubbish coasters. That was good. It wasn't too bad. Oh, we got loads of merchandise here. And as I said on the break run,
I didn't think that was that bad at all. A stampede at Port Aventura was rougher than that, in my opinion.
Yeah,
it wasn't smooth.
No. But
I like stampede. Oh my god, am I still alive after that? Oh my god. That was so rough. That has to be the worst roller coaster I've ever been on anywhere. That is worse than Furious.
Not as bad as the SLC yesterday, by a long way, I don't think.
No, I think that was worse.
Really?
At least this has some theming. It's got on a right layout. It's just not very comfortable.
Everyone's been telling me on Twitter and Facebook, Sean, bandit, you know, it's rough. Well, that was fine, for me anyway. Maybe I'm used to it. I like wooden coasters, but for me that actually wasn't that bad at all. Yes, it was rough compared to other coasters, but you know, I didn't find that too jolty at all. If you ride the coaster with it, I think a lot of people, here's a bit of advice for you when riding woodies, if you just sit there and hold on, that isn't going to help. You want to be free, moving with the ride. When you see a corner coming up, bend with it. I know you shouldn't have to do that, but if you do that, it helps a lot. And with that, like I say, I've ridden a lot rougher wooden roller coaster than that. The Blackpool wooden coasters are rougher than that, in my opinion.
Stampede is rougher than that, for sure, yeah.
Oh, I don't think it is.
At least Stampede is very uncomfortable, like with the lap bar and everything, whereas that stayed quite free, like having just clicks rather than just getting tight.
Honestly, it wasn't too bad, I didn't think.
I think the thing that makes that coaster so rough is the style of the trains and the wheels of the trains.
Yeah.
I think that's what makes that coaster so rough.
There you go. But no, it wasn't too bad at all. It wasn't the worst coaster of the trip, never mind worst KD I've ever done. You know, it was fine. I wasn't too bad on that. I quite enjoyed it. Quite a good layout as well, actually, on that.
Yeah, not bad layout.
Really. Yeah, good just, sort of out and back. And
just doesn't handle the corners very well, those Roller Coaster Corporation.
Out of the three Roller Coaster Corporations of America I've been on, that was the best one. And I've done the one at Terramitica, did one the other week, obviously, when I was out at Park Warner. And then I've done that one, and that was the best one of the three. So, there we go. Shows though, doesn't it? Everyone has different opinions on these rides, and that's what makes being an enthusiast fun, so.
I'm just relieved to be off of it.
There you go. Dean's fountain services there, look, that's a good one. It's another RCT fountain that. We've got seen a lot of RCT fountains on this trip. This is a part that wasn't built in Roller Coaster Tycoon, but I might have a go at attempting to build it, you never know. It's quite nice around here though, isn't it? Very nice sort of themed area, Santa Monica Pier. We're trying to find our way to the other water ride, which is round the back there somewhere. I'm not sure if we get to around here or not. We've got a Zamperla disco there as well, which doesn't look in operation, that. We've done enough of those anyway, I think. Have a nice day. I'm not sure where the entrance is. Maybe it's back the other way. So we're going on Sidekick. This looks quite well themed, actually. It's quite nice. Bit of theming going on. Huss classic. Huss frisbee. Quite good these are actually. Hopefully we're in on quite a long cycle. Last time I went on one of these, I was on it for a very long time. And when I mean a long time, a very, very long time, literally 6 or 7 minutes. So hopefully we'll get a long sequence. We had a really good ride though there on the Huss frisbee. It's quite intense, about a 5 minute cycle. And they get really good towards the end. Obviously, you're swinging up and down, and then right at the end, they probably speed up for about 30, 40 seconds. You know, it was really good. I really enjoyed that. We're going to go and do Alien Encounter now, which is an indoor flume-style ride. It's got some outdoor elements as well, themed all around a volcano. This is supposed to be one of the best rides here as well, so I'm looking forward to checking this out. Me and Martin and Joe have been saying this, actually. Why is this park gets so many bad reviews. It's beautiful. I mean, look at all these buildings and everything, the details. It's fantastic. I don't understand why it gets so many bad reviews. And like on TripAdvisor, you know, it's like got 3 stars and stuff. You know, I really don't understand.
And it has a lot of potential, I would say, this park.
Yeah, and next year with the brand new ride they'll be getting, will be, I'm sure, will be announced very soon what it's going to be.
I think, like, because it's so well themed, it's definitely my favourite here. Like, that we've done so far.
There we go. Alien Encounter just down the bottom there. So to get on this, you need to go right back to the main entrance, down there, sort of main street area, and down this way. Yeah, so nice fountain in the middle as well. Let's go and have a look at that. That's really nice, that is, isn't it? Look at that. Probably the best fountain of the trip, actually. I love that a lot. Dean would like that one. Like Joe just said, like, it's a bit film reel, isn't it? You know, to fit the whole movie park theme. There it is, Bermuda Triangle Alien Encounter. Let's go and give this a go. It's audio, they're playing so much audio from like Disney and Universal, and I really don't know how they're getting away with it, to be honest. Maybe no one's heard it until this vlog. Talking of the new ride, you actually see quite a bit going on from this queue line. Now, we know it's going to be manufactured by Mack, and just look there, look, you can see all the footers and look at that, that's quite interesting. I wonder what the exact layout and things is going to be, and you can sort of see construction is well in progress there, ready for 2017. Interesting how they're doing it, you know, because obviously it's going to be the 20th year. Is it the 20th year this year of this park or next year? Looking at that, it seems to say it's next year. Must be next year. I can't really see any other 20th branding anywhere, so what's it say on the map? That'll soon tell me. Is it this year? Open the map up for me, Martin. Does it say 20th year on the front?
No, I can't see it anywhere.
Oh yeah.
Oh yes.
Oh, it's this year then. Okay. Interesting then how they're opening a massive ride like that for the year 21, but there you go. It's going to be a brand new ride. Let's go on this. This looks quite very poor compared to the rest of the park, so let's have a look. The rockwork looks like it needs a clean. This rock work really needs ripping down and replacing. I mean, look at that. I thought the Tukey Splash rock work was bad, but that's awful, that. Look at it, all the foam's coming through, and yeah, that isn't great. Don't have a clue about this log flume, do we? Well, not really log flume, more of a flume, shoot the chute style ride, but I don't think this is an intimate by looking at it. That was a big drop. Wow. Look at that.
Why is there a laser in a big volcano?
I don't have a clue, but I quite like it.
Oh, okay.
It's like Valhalla. Alien Encounter. Some quite good theming in it. Nice. not expecting this.
I know, I was not.
I thought it was going to be a standard shoot the shoot.
It's quite dark here.
I didn't get anything there.
Oh,
there you go, there's the construction of the coaster, look.
Look at that.
What do you think to that?
Oh, wow, oh my God, I was not expecting that. I mean, like, you did go up the lift hill expecting just for it to be just a one drop wonder.
Turn around, you know? Straight down.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I don't know who the manufacturer is of that. Please comment below.
I'm going to have a look in a minute on the database. I need to know.
Yeah, it certainly wasn't a Hopkins ride or an Intamin.
Which is weird.
Yeah, yeah, it was weird.
That's a very old, very old, very old, very old Intamin.
Yeah, and then you go down quite long, and it seems like quite a long drop, and you go into a massive splash. You get really, really wet on the first drop. And then you go around an amazingly themed area. Really, really, yeah. Really well themed around aliens and stuff, and it had some good effects in there. Lasers as well.
It was about a 10-minute ride, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was a very, very long ride, yeah.
But yeah.
And then, as for the last drop, you do come out of the volcano, and it's very, very anticlimactic, really. A very, very.
Not a lot happened, did it?
Yeah, you don't get very wet on that last drop. One little thing though, really, it's not very interactive with the pathways around the park. Mm. So really, the only way that you will be able to get some off-ride shots of it is sort of if you go into the queue line sort of thing.
Yeah, I agree with everything Martin said there. I think you summed it all really well there. Your injury, Joe?
Yeah, it was really good. I like these columns with the electricity going through them.
Yeah, like the Tesla style. Yeah, that was good. But this looks really good. The Lost Temple. Don't have a clue what this is, but it looks well themed, whatever we're going into. Some sort of mystery dark ride or
this
something.
This is another one of those mystery rides that we've been on this.
True. We don't know. I mean, like I say, I've said it in every vlog so far. I researched the coasters, and that's about as far as I go. So with this, I don't have a clue what we're in for. Is it a walkthrough? Is it a dark ride? But whatever it is.
It could be in for a surprise. It could be one of those.
Whatever it is, gems. It looks great, doesn't it, from the queue line. So. Can have a look. Is it a walkthrough? Is it a dark ride? We'll find out.
It is below in only 60 seconds. We've had a few stops today, so if the elevator suddenly stops, don't panic. Someone will eventually get to you.
What's the course stop?
interesting. So the theme with that, we've been in there literally, what, 20, 25 minutes? Yeah. It's been a long time since we had that queue line and went down the lift. It started off brilliant. We went through the queue line, amazing theme, and as you saw, we went down in the lift, which I tried to get a bit of footage of that for you. Very dark in there though. And once we got down, we went through like what was a bit of a queue line really downstairs. I assume on a busy day, you'd wait quite a while there. Then watched another pre-show where all the crystals and things were. And then we went through, watched another pre-show, which was probably the best part of the ride in my opinion, because there you had a live actor, and you had the translation upon a screen, and she was telling you all about, don't go in, we're trying to find this, you know, it's gone missing. Oh, look at that. That is a very good animatronic, that is.
That's extremely good.
Wow. But yeah, so as I was saying, then we watched what was my favourite part of the ride there, where we had a lady explaining about don't go in, don't go in, and then, oh no, you've got to go in and find him. All the ceiling caved in, the rock work came down, all the little details in there as well, like the little screen, you know, even had stuff going on the computer. And then we got onto a simulator. Now, you know my thoughts on simulators, but it wasn't any sort of simulator. It was one similar to Shrek's Adventure, if you've ever been on that, in London, in the UK. Where it moves you in, and of course, you got a 360 sort of screen all the way around you. The problem with this was, we were on this excavation vehicle and the screen was like, I was looking to the side, the screen looked about that big from where I was all the way around, and you know, the massive piece of floor at each side with nothing going on, and I wasn't a big fan of the actual ending. But in terms of an overall experience, then it's what probably, you know, one of the best themed overall experience rides I've done, but it was so long and so much building up to the ending, which in my opinion, the ending wasn't worth it. Yeah,
flop, wasn't it?
Compared to all the build-up, but they did an amazing job with theming that.
Yeah.
And the storyline I loved as well.
Yeah, it just kind of built itself up to be something like really spectacular, and then we got to the simulator and I thought, oh.
For a family ride though, you know, that's suitable for a lot of people to ride, that is, in terms of families. But what did Martin think to the overall experience?
I enjoyed experience? That. It is a good family ride. I don't like simulators, no, but like
it was one of the better ones, wasn't
yeah
it?
Mm. You're right, as you go in, it's a very very well themed attraction, and then you go into a Nemesis Subterra style lift, which does like it give you the feeling as if you were going deep underground.
We like going
into
deep.
yeah into a temple, and then you go onto a simulator. And it gives you the feeling as if dinosaurs are attacking this temple. I mean, the last time I saw a motion simulator that was that well themed was with Star Tours at Disney.
Nothing compares to Star Tours though, does it? Star Tours is like the next one level compared to that.
But the thing is, I'm not a great fan of Star Wars.
No.
As a film, as a list of films, I'm not a great fan of that. And at least with that, it's not kind of like themed like
to an IP.
Yeah, it's not themed to an IP. That's what I was meaning.
There you go. Awesome. It was good. Wouldn't bother riding it again today, like, but it was alright, you know, quite enjoyed it.
Yes.
So we've just had numerous re-rides then on Van Helsing's factory. Absolutely fantastic indoor coach. So I'm going to make a bold statement and say that's now my favourite Gerslauer. Some of you might be thinking, what? Anubis, you know? Anubis was great, but what I love about this is the whole feeling, the experience, the helixes on it, the soundtrack, the overall thing. The coaster itself seems to be getting faster. I mean, it's really, really quick now. And like I say, Joe, you mentioned that, didn't you? It's getting quicker as we go on. Yeah. So, we're going to watch a bit of entertainment then now. Obviously, earlier on, we watched the Crazy Cops show, which was fantastic. We Can't Stop the Beat, we saw a bit of when we were having lunch, and the Movie Park Parade, which is held at 3 o'clock, which is basically the famous time at Disney for holding the parade. So, we watched a bit of a poor parade the other day at Plopsaland, didn't we?
Yeah, we did. It had about five cars to it. This one should be a little bit better, to be honest, because obviously owned by Park Warner, this park, and they seem to have quite a few characters.
There's a lot going around. We'll have characters, yeah. I reckon we'll have motorbikes, I reckon we'll have all the cars from the stunt show, we'll have a quad bike, we'll have loads of stuff, I reckon, in this one. I reckon they'll be doing wheelies down here, or maybe not, but we'll find out. So it's coming up in a few minutes, so we'll have a little look at the parade here at Movie Park Germany. What a park.
Boys and girls, meine Damen und Herren, liebe Jungen und Mädchen, Movie Pop Germany proudly presents Hollywood.
After the parade, then we're going to go and ride Time Riders. Again, another mystery, some sort of dark ride. I think after seeing the parade, it might be a simulator, looking at the final float. Hope it's not a simulator though, but we can hopefully some good theming inside, even if it is. We've got a bit of smoke on the outside. How good was that parade? Yes, it was quite short, probably around 5 minutes long, but it had a really catchy soundtrack by I'm a School, made by the guys that we saw, you know, when we was at Wallaby Belgium. So yeah, really good parade, really good feel, good floats. Some bigger floats actually on there than what was at Plopsaland and also when I was at Park Warner. What do you guys think?
Really nice.
It's
one of the better parades you've seen actually.
Very feel good.
Yeah,
but
not a big one, but it's just nice.
I like the old cars in that.
Yeah, yeah.
We had some really good cars, didn't we?
Cars, yeah, the hot rods.
Yeah, yeah, it's good.
That was a really good parade. It was short, and it had but it really had a good, catchy song to it.
Good
feel. Everybody going. And I tell you, and it just builds up everybody's energy around the park, and there's no reason why this park can't get the gate figures, I tell you.
Yeah, we're really struggling to see why this park struggles.
You need to get yourself out of here because it's got a very, very American feel to it. And I really can't see why this park doesn't get the gate figures.
Yeah, it's hopefully the new ride next year will definitely bring people in. I'm sure they'll step up the marketing for that later on. Obviously, we are still quite early in 2016, we're going to be marketing that, but hopefully soon. We need big posters on the entrance. You guys, if you're watching this, you need to be pushing this at this park. If any other manager are watching it, you need to really be pushing that new ride, because if we didn't go down that end of the park and ride the Flume ride, we wouldn't have even known there was a new ride coming next year. You need posters around this park and let people know that there's a new ride coming. So, right, we're going to give this a go. Time Raiders, I'm going to say Raiders then. Hopefully this will be decent. Let's have a little look at the restrictions board. Eating, drinking, smoking, chewing gum. Please remain seated during the ride. So no, it's not a walkthrough. Epilepsy, back problems. The same usual stuff really. So hopefully we'll see something quite unique in here. So we'll go in and tell you about it when we come out.
Thank you. it finished it. Then feel me. A bicycle allow us just for thousands it. Dieser riesige Kreatur ist ein reiner Pflanzenbau.
Another simulator! Yeah! Come on, we're all simulators! Best rides ever! Simulators! Yes! Another simulator on it.
Well, Sean had to wake me up there. I was starting to fall asleep on that, yeah.
I think we all were.
I felt like changing the switches just like he does in the Mr. Bean disaster movie there. I felt like I had to.
We knew the guy in the video, didn't we?
Yeah, John Cleese from The Fawlty Towers, it was in that. Like, the whole way through as well, not just like featured, just in it. He was the bad professor that made this time machine.
Yeah. That's the theme of the ride.
Yeah, it's time machine.
Yeah, we go inside like a library at the start, and then it's been taken over because he's bored of reading books, I assume, and wants to, do crazy inventions. But what a waste of a warehouse that was. You know, waste of a warehouse. It was well themed though, given that. And obviously, after we went out, you saw a few different GoPro shots there. We had the first, obviously, pre-show room. Then we sat down around semicircle, and then we watched a bit of video and a bit of a lighting effect and lasers and stuff, but nothing amazing really happened. And then we went on the simulator. You're all right, have we got a vlog? Hey, you vlog, Bobby? No, you can come in it. There you go. Hello, there you go. What's that?
What's your YouTube channel?
Theme Park Worldwide on the t-shirt there. Look, Theme Park Worldwide. Theme Park Worldwide. Yeah. Are you all having a good day?
Yes.
What's been your favorite ride so far?
Free fall.
You like free fall? You like a big long drop? What's been your favourite?
That one was very good.
You like that? No, it's very bad.
No.
Van Helsing Factory, have you been on that?
Yeah,
Factory. Hashtag the Factory. Well, have a good day, ladies.
Thank you.
Enjoy yourself. Bye. See you later. Ta-ra, have a good ride. Time to ride Mystery River. And we're literally just saying, actually, you know, there's so many surprises at this park. And
there is a lot more here than I was expecting. I mean, I don't think there are as many quantity of rides, but the quality and the length of the rides is quite long.
Like, theming's great. I mean, just look at this for a queue line. What do you think, what type of ride do you think we're about to ride now? If I said to you an Intamin Rapids, you know, you'd think, what the hell, wouldn't you? But that's what we are getting to ride.
Is this old cattle pen?
They're all cattle pen or pre-show for what they've cut out. People just want to get on a rapids. They don't want to be bored by a pre-show. They like the pre-shows here, don't they?
Yeah.
You don't need a pre-show for rapids. Let's go and have a go. Some right little gems. We also just found out there's another dart ride. There's an Ice Age dart ride next door to this as well from Intamin. So let's check that out as well. Let's go for a ride on the rapids. Oh, we're going to get KFC.
Oh, wow.
Let's find out.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my God. What a gem.
This park is a gem.
Gem 106. I know. Wow, this looks good. So underrated. What other rapids ride in the world has a turntable like that?
I can't think of one.
Thank you.
This is different. That was really nice in there. Look at this. Here we go. How was that? What the hell? What the hell is going on there? Whoa! This is really strange, but really good. Look at this. Very well themed.
Oh!
Oh, where's Merlin? There we go, might get a bit now. Come on. The rot works a bit worse for wear again. It's a very dated rapids, but it's got some good theming.
It's quite a dated park, but I've been very, very impressed with it.
Seems to be the two water rides that haven't had much maintenance go on really in terms of keeping them looking good. Very impressive though, this has got a lot of potential if it was all cleaned up a bit. Who dares enter the Cave of Wonders? Come on, give me a bit of KFC in the cave, come on. Oh, it's dark in here. Come on. Oh, look at that. The unicorn. Oh! I got some. This is very good. Look at this. This is a big piece of theming. I don't know how well this is picking up. We got a star cluster laser on that. That was very nice. That was. It was definitely my top five rapids, I'd say. Some really good theming. No effects in there. No waterfalls or anything like that, but it was good in terms of a rapids. Take the theming away, it wasn't a very good rapids. We didn't really get much, but it got going quite fast. We didn't really get wet. I mean, literally nothing. I got one little spot there on my shorts. But the station platform, the turntable, wow. I mean, it was crazy, that was. I couldn't believe it. All that theming around there, all the ceiling was done, and throughout the ride it kept going outside, then inside, and there's some loads of tunnels. To have a water ride inside is really good, and it was fantastic. Riding stuff like that makes me realise, though, how lucky we are to have Valhalla back home, because Valhalla, yeah. You look at Valhalla and you look at that and you think, oh my God, you know, we're so lucky to have Valhalla back home. But yeah, it was fantastic, really good rapids. Do you enjoy it, Martin?
That was a good rapid, so I really, really enjoyed
that. Oh, he's
got
that. His cool yeah. Shades on again.
I took them off now because we've actually just come into a But it was a good rapids. It was very, very well themed. You didn't get very wet. We didn't get any KFC mega waves or anything like that.
We got a bit of a Pizza Hut Express.
I think the main problem with this park is the fact that it's got quite a few rides that are sort of like hidden sort of thing, down the back corner of the park sort of thing. So I don't know what is going on here, whether or not people have came here and they didn't go on many rides that they didn't actually realise were here or something like that.
Maybe. Like this, we didn't have a clue. This is Ice Age Adventure. Yes, they've got the Ice Age No Time for Nuts film down the other end of the park, but here we've got a dark ride. And when I looked on the Water Rides database, just found out it was an Intamin. Obviously, it's some sort of boat ride, so hopefully this will be quite good. It doesn't look like it's got a big queue, so obviously it is a Monday today on the mega trip, so we've got quite a nice quiet park. But no, like, I don't understand why this park's got as much stick. I mean, Martin was mentioned a good point. I said to these guys, look, you know, I think this is probably going to be the weakest park of the trip. And it's definitely up there as probably the best in terms of, you know, so far.
In terms of the themed rides and in terms of the whole overall feel of the park, it's very, very nice. But in terms of the coasters, this park, that's
quite
weak. Lacking. Maybe until next year.
We'll soon find out. Good rapids though, wasn't it, Joe? Good rapids.
Yes, rapids. Fast, but just not much wet.
And there we go. Well, let's go and ride this. This could be awful. It could be great. Who knows? Let's go and have a little Ice Age adventure. Say about that rock work, then turn a corner and a bit more rock work. Then
do you want to hear a good point?
Go on.
The ride system was good.
It was. Tell them a bit about the ride system.
Well, I like the lift hill in particular, where you went up the lift and then it touched you nice and forward, and then down the drop you go. It was nice.
Yeah, the drop. Wow. I don't think the camera picked it up that good, really. It was like a slanted, curved drop, which was quite good. But no, the animatronics. I'm like I say, when I was on there, I'm surprised that, you know, the company who own Ice Age let that thing go on. I mean, you know, you wouldn't see that at a Disney park. I'm surprised that's still allowed to operate, but yeah, it wasn't that good, that. One of my weakest rides here.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm glad we've done it. Ride system was great, actually. It's got so much potential. Do you reckon that used to be themed to something else? Comment below. I reckon that used to be themed to something else before it was Ice Age.
Yeah, absolutely.
You can tell it looks like, you know.
Be. No, I could tell that. No, I liked that ride. I do not agree with these guys at all. I really liked it. That was the best Ice Age ride I've been on.
I'd agree with that, yeah, but I haven't really done many Ice Age themed things, to be honest.
The biggest flaw
I haven't.
Was where they're running up the cliff, and they're all like behind each other. It was hilarious when we're on there. They were going up that way. It's just a sliding, it's like a sliding trestle that goes all the way across with the characters, and then it stops, and then they come the other way and do that. But then when it stopped, the characters were still halfway in shot. So you could see that there was more of them than just like one of them.
Maybe because, you know what, I've been around some of the world's best rides. There we go for this log flume. Down that way. I've been on some of the world's best rides, some of the world's best dark rides, and it takes a lot to impress me these days. You know, go back 5 years ago and if I'd have ridden that, I'd probably thought, oh yeah, it was actually all right, but it takes a lot to get me going these days, and now I wasn't a huge fan of that.
We're going on Dora now.
Yeah, Dora's World Voyage.
Yeah.
Dora's River Adventure.
Say hello in French, we say bonjour.
Yeah, say hello in China, we also say mi hao. Going to have a ride on Dora. We love a good ride on Dora. She loves a good ride from us, so we'll go and enjoy this one. Oh, Dora might make you a bit wet on this one.
heavily themed tunnel. So we had a bit of a wet one just, and we're on the small drop. I think the big one's going to be in for a surprise. Right there, Martin, in the front.
Yeah, I like this. I like what they have done with this off-the-shelf log flume.
You can tell it was a traveller.
Yeah. It's a travelling off-the-shelf amusement park log flume. But they themed it around Dora the Explorer with a load of rocks around it. So it's very, very wealthy, cheap ride.
We've done a good job of the theming. I mean, yeah, it was quite good. We've just had some sad news, but I'm going to keep you in suspense till we come off the ride. And I'll tell you about that sad news. Let's go down the big drop. Yeah, that was wet. My shoes are soaked. Absolutely soaked. Oh, no, it was a bit of a soaker. Shorts are a bit wet, but yeah, I needed that. I was getting a bit hot before. So yeah, as I just mentioned, we've had some sad news and just come straight in off Facebook from the Fantasyland official Facebook page about their brand new themed area and the two roller coasters in there. Of course, we've got an Intamin launch coaster in there and we've also got a Vekoma Junior Boomerang. Unfortunately, these rides aren't going to be ready for our visit later this week, which is sad. But I said to these guys, you know, that wasn't the main reason for Fantasyland. There's so much more there to see, such as Talokan, the Top Spin, Windjammers, a fantastic indoor marathon spinning coaster, Black Mamba, River Quest. So many really good rides at that park. Obviously, it's sad news that we're not going to be riding Taron, but it's going to be opening the end of June. Start of July, you know, so we've got, I haven't watched the video fully yet, but like I say, so you've got the opening date, a few different like preview days before that, so sad news, isn't it, guys? Sad news.
I am sad about that, yeah.
But we'll get to see it, and we'll get to, you know, look at the ride.
Oh, it's a shame that we won't get to ride any new coasters for 2016 this trip anymore.
Yeah, because we did Pulsar, which was a great coaster, Pulsar, and we did Lost Gravity.
Yeah, we did.
Unfortunately, you know, it's sad news, but don't worry, Taron will be coming off Theme Park Worldwide this year, and I'll be out there. Don't you worry about that. Yeah, this is not very good. Never been on one of these before.
No, neither have I. Probably won't be going on one again either.
I won't rush to go on one again. Nice views though.
Yeah. I've lots of factories around this area of Germany.
Such a small park when you love them up here, but there's so much inside. Some real hidden gems. Oh, you can't come to Germany and not have a bratwurst. Look at this, I love a good bratwurst. I mean, people have told me before you don't get proper bratwurst at theme parks, but I really enjoy these. Look at that. Looks so nice. The other guys are off to get a Ben and Jerry's over there. Look. Coming towards the end of our day here at Movie Park Germany. And what a fantastic day we've had. My favourite park of the trip so far. Not so strong in terms of coasters, such as Wallaby Holland, but it's got a really nice atmosphere and just everything's been thought about here. Theming details and the buildings. It's just a really nice park and it's been great to share it with some really good company as well. Fantastic, let's get some last re-rides in. Factory. Just on the mug hunt, we've got one for the SLC. And then we've got two for Bandit. So we've got all three of those.
Next weekend stop the beach show, which will begin in 15 minutes on stage at the New York City Plaza.
I can't have postcards.
Postcards.
If only it was actually that good. On the mug hunt, right, over to Van Helsing's factory for a few re-rides and some more mug action. I'm a mug for mugs. Muggage. Absolutely love Van Helsing's factory. It's one of those rides that the first time you go on it, you're looking round for things and you know that it's going to be great. And then even after nearly 20 rides that me and Joe have had, you know, you're still finding new things at the end. It's a fantastic experience. And yeah, I've got some merchandise. You got some really good stuff like clocks and loads of stuff. You even got a massive
like, what is it, like an axe over here? I mean, look at this. The fact you can buy this stuff in a theme park over here. Look at that. 99 euros.
Yeah, I was tempted to buy it. I don't know if I will.
Get that back on the ferry. Look at some of this though. You can just buy these at theme parks everywhere. I mean, imagine a park like Alton Towers selling a knife in Towers Trading. It just wouldn't happen, would it? Best always. That was a really, really good ride. And I've got these mugs just down here. We've got a bat mug, which is quite nice. Got this mug over here. That means I've got, what, 5 mugs so far today from this park, which is great. That's how I love it. There you go, you can even buy a skeleton and even buy the mirror there. Look at this. Right, we're gonna head down to the entrance, have a look in the big gift shop, and that'll sum up our day here at Movie Park Germany. Mugs, 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 mugs. Sean loves mugs. What you got there? You got mugs. Over here, there's mugs. There is mugs, 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 mugs. Which one shall I buy? Mugs, mugs. Mugs. So many. So, we were just speaking to a really nice lady, and if you managed to find the channel, then hello and thank you for watching. And she said, yeah, there's more mugs. Got chatting to her, you know, that I like mugs. And I've got over 300 of them. She said, go down there, you know, there's more in the main gift shop. I thought that was the main mug shop. But look at this, guys. This is the best set of mugs I've ever seen. Look at this. Look at that. Full of mugs. All to do with the park. That is ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. Look at that. Look at that. Oh, my God, look at that. What is it? Look at it. This is like the happiest day of my life, guys. Best park in Europe. But no, seriously, look at that. That is how to make me happy. I think they knew we were coming. They were like, right, we need to get some mugs ordered. Look at that. This park ain't gonna be struggling by the time I finish spending in this gift shop, is it? Look at that. It's a memorable day, this, for Theme Park Worldwide. A memorable day. What an absolutely amazing day we've had here at Movie Park Germany. Earlier on when we were stood at the turnstiles just here, I thought, you know what? You know, it's gonna be a good park, but it's not gonna be, you know, one of our favorites of the trip. I'm leaving with a really special feeling about this park, and just it's got a very magical feel to it. It's a very good movie park, you know, and obviously using all the different themed rides, and it's not really got themed areas as such, but the themed rides are absolutely fantastic, and all the stuff we've experienced here today has been absolutely fantastic. It's been a great park, and something I've really enjoyed. Now sum up a bit more on our car journey home. So we're gonna leave the park, and I've got my mugs just here. We'll catch up with Joe and Martin as well and what they thought of this park. But I think it's been absolutely stunning. We'll get in the car, start making our way back to the caravan park. It's only an hour away from here. And yeah, give you our review of this fantastic park.
Pringles.
Yeah. Pringles.
Is that the Port Ventura vlog from like November 2013 at Christmas? Yeah. Port Ventura vlog where you just like tipped a load of crisps over your head.
Yeah. I'm not going to do it with Pringles, they're too expensive, mate.
Yeah.
But today's been really good. We had a nice journey back, a nice couple of hours chill out now, just to relax and really think about what we've experienced at the park today. I've also filmed the on-location episode of Theme Park Worldwide, the show, from our lovely caravan, so make sure you do check that out on the channel, which was last week's episode. We've had a great day then today. I'm going to start with Martin. What was your thoughts on Movie Park, Germany.
I really liked Movie Park. It is very much a small park that has a lot of character and a good fun feel to it. Yeah, I really liked it. It is kind of a park that I've actually fell in love with. A small little park that I never actually had much thoughts on at the start, because of as soon as we arrived at the gates, I kind of thought to myself that the kiosks where you buy your tickets were looked they were looking a bit dated, and from the actual reviews of the park, I was expecting it to be a bit dirty, and I wasn't really expecting much. But overall, I actually really, really loved it, and I would actually love to go back. So far on this trip, definitely the best park of the trip. May not have all the coasters, but it's definitely got the theming, and it definitely just has that, I don't know what it is about the park that just makes it a lovely park to just walk around and just be around, to be honest. The highlight of the day for me would definitely have to be the stunt show, and also the actual parade.
You enjoyed the entertainment then?
Yeah, I did.
In terms of a favourite ride, what would you say it is at that park?
Van Helsing's Factory, easily.
I wrote a text. Hi, Charlotte.
And I know what you're thinking. How can you call a Gerstler your favourite ride in a park? But obviously that park doesn't really have much else in the way of rides. But, yeah.
Theming.
The theming on Van Helsing's Factory is just amazing. It really is the best themed Gerstlau I have ever been on.
There you go.
I'm not a great fan of Gerstlauers. Obviously, I love my B&Ms, but my partner doesn't have any B&Ms. But
that's to come later this week.
Yeah.
But there you go. Fair review from Mr. Hotwood there. So over to the one and only in the Lost Gravity cap, Joe Beasley. What did you think of your day at Movie Park, Germany?
Well, the SLC, obviously, is just a massive highlight.
Compared to El Condor, anyway.
Bandit, I mean, what a coaster. in all seriousness, though, probably just the overall park's charm. It has a lot of charm. I don't know what it is about it. It's just like a lovely place to be, especially that Hollywood Boulevard area.
Mm.
Really, really nice. I could sit there all day.
You've not been to Universal Studios before, have you, so?
No.
It kind of gives you a feel, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does, yeah. And it's so much closer to home than, you know, all of them as well. So, you know, it's just a really nice park to just sort of be in, I think. It reminds me a bit of PA. Like, every time I go back every once in a while, I just think, this is nice. You know what I mean?
This is nice.
This is nice.
Favourite ride?
Favourite ride, obviously, Van Helsing's Factory. The best ride of the trip so far for me.
We've said that a lot, haven't we?
Yeah, it's so good. I just love that ride so much.
Can Troy top it tomorrow?
And the soundtrack's great. There's just not one thing I'd change about it. That's it.
There you go. Zach's finishing me crisps. Right. So yeah, it was a really good part. I really enjoyed the atmosphere there. It was fantastic. What I absolutely loved was how it felt like a Universal style park. And I do enjoy Universal, but I don't like how it screens all the time. With this, there was actually a lot of attractions, what featured screens, but there was a really good combination of theming as well. It was that good that my voice has gone today. So you know I've had a good day when my voice goes. So today's got to be the best day of the trip so far. You know, best park of the trip so far. Best coaster of the trip so far is Van Helsing's Factory, as we like to just call it, Factory. So hashtag TBW Factory.
Factory, factory. Dispatch.
Me and Joe, like I say at the end, we had 11 rides without, you know, having to leave the actual train, which was great. You know, it was fantastic. Brilliant coaster.
Two staff on there were lovely.
Two staff were lovely. So big shout out to you guys. It's been amazing. Really good park. Like I say, come and check it out. I really don't see why that park doesn't get better reviews, but hopefully now you guys have seen our vlog, you'll go and check that park out. I'm going to shut up because my voice is going. I'm going to get some sleep. I'm going to rest up because tomorrow it's time for our final new park of the trip for me, which is Toverland. It's 15 minutes from where we're staying at our secret campsite location, which isn't secret because I revealed it yesterday. But yeah, tomorrow's Toverland. We'll see him on the drive up there. And tomorrow we get to ride Troy, a GCI wooden roller coaster that opened in 2007. I can't wait for Troy.
I can't either.
Could be a brilliant ride. Could be the best coaster of the trip so far.
15 minutes away. That's the best part of it.
Let's drive it in the TPW mobile over there. See you in the morning, Joe. Have a good sleep. We'll see you in the morning. Like I say, as I've said in all these vlogs, it's a continuation vlog. Vlog number 5 coming up tomorrow from Toverland. Make sure you do check it out. That is it from us guys for now. And that means it's time to cue those credits. See you at Toverland.